The latest on the Brookfield salon shooting, the attorney for one of the victims is coming to the defense of the Brown Deer Police Department, which answered repeated calls about the gunman over several years.
And 12 News reporter Nick Bohr joins us live from the scene of that shooting in Brookfield with new information.
And Jason, there certainly seems to be a need to understand the actions of Radcliffe Houghton here at Ozana on Sunday. In an unusual press release today issued through Brown Deer Police, the attorney says she's tired of what she calls misinformation about the from the media about Zena Houghton's interactions with Brown Deer Police and the department's role in trying to get Zena away from her husband. The strained marriage of Zena and Radcliffe Houghton came to an end here Sunday, along with their lives and the lives of two other Ozana Spa workers. Now Zena's lawyer is commenting on her interactions with Zena in the months leading up to the killings. Attorney Lisa Martin has denied our request for an interview, but recorded a statement with Brown Deer Police, but didn't want her face shown.
She was very afraid that if the police were involved in arresting him, that he would do exactly what he had said he would do, and that was to kill her and to burn her family with gasoline.
Martin represented Zena as she obtained a restraining order against Radcliffe last week.
On the morning of October 4th, when she said he was angrier than she had ever seen him before, and she was certain that if she stayed there and waited for him, as he demanded she do, he demanded she call into work sick and stand there and wait for him and give him all the passcodes for her phone and give him access to her bank accounts, that something terrible would happen.
Later that day, Radcliffe showed up at Ozana and slashed Zena's tires. And Martin says Zena was finally moved to get a divorce and a restraining order.
Zena truly appreciated all of the work that Brown Deer did to help her. You got through to her. And it takes a long time to get through to victims of domestic abuse.
Martin says other media outlets have mistakenly reported that Houghton was never arrested, which he was, though never convicted, and says the widely criticized standoff at their home last year is misinformed. She shares Zena's thoughts on the police actions that night on 12 News at 6. Reporting live in Brookfield, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.